Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to input array elements in Java. So let's get started. So first we need to input the array length from the user. So first let me have a variable n for that. So it's going to be int n, and we just have a print statement. It's going to be system.out.print, and we are just going to have it's out. Enter array size, and next thing we will be using the scanner class. So for using the scanner class, we need to import from util package. So it's going to be import java.util. I wouldn't recommend you to import the entire util package, so just be specific with the class. Okay, it's going to be scanner, yeah, this one. So this is now fine, and just come to the next line. It's going to be scanner with a capital S. I will name the variable as input equal to new scanner, and it's going to be system.in. Okay, so this is my scanner class, and next thing is going to be the variable n. So n equal to input dot next int. Okay, so don't use next line, it's going to be next int because we are getting a variable of type integer. Okay, so now we are done with this. So next thing what we will be doing is we will be getting the array elements. Okay, we will be declaring the array first, and then we will be getting the array elements with the help of a for loop. So for initializing array, we need to like initialize with the array length so that it creates the same size in the memory. So it's going to be int. I am creating array of type integer. Okay, so you can create it of type anything, string, float, anything. So int, use the square bracket over here, space, you need to specify the array name. I will specify it as arr equal to new int, and within bracket you need to specify the integer or the size, which is n in our case, yeah, the variable basically. So you can also directly specify a number like 10 or anything like that, but I will just like, you know, get the input size also from the user. So this is going to be it. This is now fine. So now we are done initializing the array. Next thing, we will be using a for loop and getting the variables. So before that for loop, let's just have a print statement. I will just now copy it and paste it. So this time here it's going to be enter array elements, and yeah, and just come to the next line. It's going to be for int I equal to 0, I less than n, which is the size of our array. Okay, so just put n over here, n, and I plus plus. And in the next line, again we will be using this particular input, okay, input object of the scanner class. But here we will be using our array. Okay, so it's going to be array, this one, our array name, array of I equal to input dot next in. So the exact same thing that we have done for our number n, but in this case we will be using array of I, because through this way, through this help of the for loop, we will be able to access each and every index present in our array. So it's going to be array of 0, array of 1, array of 2, array of 3, till array of n. So that many times we will be getting the input numbers. I hope this made sense to you. That's why we are like doing with the for loop. In this case, we aren't having any for loop, so this particular step will be repeated for only one time. But since we are having this input of next int within this for loop will be running till n times, till all the elements are getting like stored in our array of I. So array of 0 till array of n. So that many times we'll be getting the input over here. So once you're done getting the input, next thing you need to just print it. So for printing it, it's so simple. I will just now copy it. I'll just now copy it and just paste the exact same thing. And I'll just have array elements, and it's going to be, just copy it again, paste it, and rather than having this, I will just have it as array of I. Okay. That's it. That's the code, guys. So now let me just now run and check if it's working. So it's showing a green mark. Yeah. So this is fine. No worries. Just a warning. It's fine. So I'll just go and Java C to compile. Yeah, there aren't any errors. And Java to view the output. So enter the array size, which is this particular part. Okay. The program control is over here. We need to give only one input. So I will give the input as 5. After that, it will be coming here. Enter array elements. And here we will be input n times. So our n in this case is 5, so we need to input 5 numbers. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and in each iteration these numbers will be accessed by input.nextint, and it will be stored in arr of 5. So error of 0 will be 1, I value gets incremented, I becomes 1, error of 1 will be stored as 2, exact same thing, error of 2 will be stored as 3, same thing goes on. So we have entered 5 elements. So if I just now hit enter, we will be getting array elements and the output. So if I just now hit enter, so here you can see that I'm getting array elements and the output. So this is like the simplest way how you can get array input in Java. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Thread Operations, as well as Figma. So check those videos, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.